the energy density is very less. So we wanted to improve the energy density of the system. That's why we are working towards this one. Okay, so as we discussed earlier, so carbon, so electric double layer capacitors, as I told you, carbon material behave like this. Similarly, metal oxides behave like the pseudo capacitance and combinations which can give rise to the hybrid. So what we have to do is the materials. So starting with the simple material, then go for composite, then is there any betterment with the perovskite materials, then what is the advantage of 2D materials? This one we can do it in a faster way. Just logic, we are not going to discuss any research content in that. Okay, so why manganese oxide, why we are choosing means, so it has a very simple cheap material, but we have a different form of oxides, okay, oxidation states, +2 to +7, and it also exists in a different form, alpha, beta, gamma, like that. There are 5 to 6 forms of this MnO2 with a different structural orientations. Okay, so we prepared all forms like alpha, beta, gamma, and don't worry about this graph. So it is, if it is giving CV curve, normally it gives a rectangular shape more or less, and CGD it is like a as I discussed, it is a triangular one. Okay, so from that you can see it is a CV, it is a CGD. And one more discussion is like a EAS, that's nothing but a electrochemical impedance spectroscopy, where you can study the charge transfer mechanism. Okay, that's all. With these three things, you can tell about your material, whether it is electrochemically good or what kind of a output you can get. Okay, then we did the measurements, what we have told. Then we tabulated. So we found that alpha as well as gamma, which can give the high capacitance, specific capacitance like 265 and 257. Okay. So you take alpha for a case. And again, I wanted to make a composite. Okay, directly composite, whether there is an increase in the specific capacitance. So because so these materials give the high ionic conductivity, better charge transfers, like that. There are some advantages, so I made it in a composite form. There also you can do the same studies. They don't worry about this graph and all. So you can find the value, okay, the specific capacitance when it is composited with the 3:1 form of this composition. So which can give rise to 412. Okay, previously it is like a 260 around. Now it is highest efficiency as 412 per gram. Okay, so how to improve like composite form? Similarly, but when you go for a higher scan rate, okay, but it is difficult to maintain it, the specific capacitance at higher scan rate. That means so you have to apply the more voltage with respect to time, then this can lose the specific capacitance in a faster way, so that it is not much useful. Okay, when you subjected to higher scan rate also, it can be stable. So we can look for a LA based perovskite material. Perovskite material means it has some structure like a ABO3 structure. So you can A as a so lanthanum based materials you can use, and B is the transition materials, so that you can form like a this kind of material ABO3. Okay, like a lanthanum, Mn is a transition O3 form. So this material has some advantages like thermal stability is high and structural stability also very high, but there are some problem in this material like agglomeration. So when you prepare, because it needs high temperature to prepare, so it can form agglomeration. So if the agglomeration is more, sometimes it may not be useful, or less surface area. Okay, so when you want to make a nanomaterial form, then only you can have a higher surface area, or you can make like a porosity. So these are all the problems in this material. So if you rectify, will it useful for some applications like that? We made it. Okay, first one, you can make an agglomeration free LaMnO3 material by adding the lemon juice in the preparation. Okay, so in lemon juice contains citric acid as well as the ascorbic acid. So normally citric acid is a surfactant, so which can give a less agglomeration as well as structure aided agent. Okay, so even if it is in the natural form, okay, then it may be more useful. So that we thought and we made it. We make a agglomeration free material and it can be useful for some better specific capacitance also. For example, when it is made in normal way, normal chemical method, so on seeing this CV curve, you might have seen that. So if the surface area is more, so you will have a more specific capacitance. So it is related with the specific capacitance. So when it is a normal way, so you have a less specific capacitance when compared with the, when it is added with the lemon juice, so which can give rise to the better specific capacitance. Okay, so like that, your approach for is very important for research. So these are all the some related stuffs. So I can skip this one. And next one is approach is that you can make a porous kind of a material. Okay, so if you make it in a porous form, so that can give the better specific capacitance when it is compared with the normal. For example, this is a porous one, so which is in red color, cyclic potometer graph, which is in red color, so which can have a more area under this curve. So that means so the specific capacitance is more when compared with the spherically prepared one, okay, normal method. So, and also one more interesting thing is while doing the electrochemical process, so it can create channels. For example, this pores, when it is subjected to the electrochemical process, so these pores are joined together and it forms a channel like things inside the material. So when it is channels are created, so these ions intercalation is very easy, and so that it can be come for longer cycles, like more than 1 lakh cycles without any degradation. So that is the best efficiency about this material. Okay, for example, I can tell you in a very rough way. For example, you are staying in a hostel and your department is in some other space. In between you have a ground. Okay, normally people used to go inside the ground and they make a path. Okay, repeatedly people go and make a path. Similar way, this channel also created by making the electrochemical way. So next I will talk within 2 to 3 minutes about the 2D materials. So why we are going for 2D materials means it has a high surface area. Okay, 2D means two dimensional materials. Okay, you might be knowing that graphene sheet, no? So similar, like this is also one of the materials for energy storage, because high storage area, super flexibility, better transparency and mechanical stability also. And we have chosen as a molybdenum disulfide as a material because it has like a sheet like structure, so this can behave like a EDLC, and it has a molybdenum atoms inside, so this can transfer from some oxidation, change in the oxidant state, so this can give rise to the pseudo capacitance. So it is a combination of these two, so which can give rise to the better material. And also this material is a like a graphene sheet, okay, more flexible nature. So whatever you wanted to make a flexible devices, so one can use this kind of a 2D materials. These are also recent trends in this type of research. So it has three forms. Okay, it has some polymorphs. That means different forms. It may be in the form of semiconducting or metallic nature. This 1, 2, 3 and all, it's the layers. How many layers can be stacked accordingly, it can give. And here the metallic form is more interesting because the conductivity is very high when compared with the semiconducting nature. So we are preparing conducting form with a different composition. Okay, I made it in a different composition, metallic moisture first one prepared, and it is combined with RGO, reduced carbon oxides, graphene oxides, and you have another material called GC3N4 and another material called carbon sphere. So same metallic MOS2 is make in the form of composites, and we make a we studied the one, and finally we found that this carbon based material which can give rise to the better electrochemical outputs, and we made this material for some applications. Like we glow the using this material, we can glow the LED also. Like it is form of you make a supercapacitor, okay, positive as well as it's called symmetric capacitor. That means so same material which can be act like a positive and negative. Then you can put the some electrolyte in between. Then it can be charged and discharged so that it can lighten the LED also. Okay, but it is like it's a primitive stage, so we don't have much output out of them. So we have some practical demonstration. So if you allow me, so that I can make after concluding, I can show the practical demonstration so that you can see the things also. So I make a conclusions like that. So we are work on different materials like oxides and sulfides, and any shape and size can be controlled with the experimental parameters, and this can be subjected for energy as well as environmental applications. And so maybe we have done some we have tried some practical applications. Scaling up is the next stage. Thank you. I acknowledge to my all students, because students are only the main source of output, and also we have a funding agency, DST, DRDO, DST Nano Mission, the cube, and our institute funding everything, MHRD also. Okay, thank you. So I will stop here, and I will show the demonstration. Okay, after that we can have a session. Okay, I'll share the another content.
Dear participants, now it's time for asking questions.
I will show one demonstration whether it's possible.
Okay, okay, sir. Okay, sir.
Okay, one minute. One. Yes, so we made some device like that. So we have a series of device, supercapacitor material. Okay, now initially it is charged. Okay, we have to charge. Okay, storage means you can give the charge. So the charging is done with the battery for a minute. Okay, so now it is charging, and the device charged now. During the charge, this material is get charged. So after that, we can remove the battery, and it is for discharge. So there is the LED is here. Maybe after we start glowing, then you can see the things also. So can you able to see the things?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. So now, after charging, this can be glowed using this our material. Okay. Now it is glowing. That means it is discharged and it is useful for some applications. Okay, around 1 minute it is charged and it is around 30 to 40 seconds. This can be blown. Okay. Around 45 seconds. Okay. And once. Okay, thank you for listening, and sorry, I don't know whether I have done it in a useful way or not. I don't know, maybe students can tell. Yes, sir. I didn't put on the video because sometimes it can exhaust in a faster way. Net can be exhausted. I am in house also, so limited resource. So I didn't switch on the things. Yes, sir. Any questions from students?
Dear participants, in case if you have any questions, you can please note them on the chat window, or you can unmute and you can speak to the resource person, please.
I exhausted because like morning I have a beta class. So.
Oh, okay, sir. Okay, sir.
Okay, no problem. Can ask.
Or else, participants, you can send in the questions to us. We will route it to the resource person, or you can note down the email ID of the resource person and get in touch with them later.
Okay.
Right. So, once again, we would like to thank you, sir, for your resource support, and looking forward to your constant and continued guidance and support in our future endeavors also, sir.
Thank you, sir. Is it useful for... students are not, I don't know.
On the final day, we will take the feedback. We will certainly share with you the feedback.
Okay. Sir. Okay. Yes. Sir. Thank you. Thank you. Okay,
thank you very much, sir. Thank you. Dear students, we are concluding this lecture for today. And tomorrow morning, we will have the lecture at 10 a.m. We will start the lecture at 10 a.m. So we request all the participants to be ready by 9:45 on the online platform. We will have Dr. Stephanie Hernandez from the US, from the Seagate Research Group. She will deliver the first lecture. And tomorrow being the last day, we will also have the valedictory at 3:15 p.m. So we have three sessions for tomorrow. And by around 4 o'clock, everything should be over, including the valedictory session, everything will be over. So we request you to kindly log in tomorrow by 9:45 a.m. so that we are ready for the first session. Thank you very much.
Thank you for giving me the opportunity.
Thank you.
Thank you for the students for listening. Thank you.
Yes.